BestBookBits.com presents 12 Pillars by Chris Widener and Jim Rohn. This new novel by Jim Rohn and Chris Widener will inspire you to take your life to the next level and beyond. It will challenge and encourage you to become the best that you can be. 12 Pillars blends together the fundamental principles and teachings of Jim Rohn and the Jim Rohn 1-Year Success Plan. And with the help of Chris Widener, those principles have been weaved into a unique tapestry of a fictional account of three characters, Michael, Charlie, and Mr. Davis. Here are a few lessons that you will discover in the 12 Pillars of Success. Live a life of three-dimensional health, the gift of relationships, achieving your goals, and the proper use of time. Surrounding yourself with the best people, becoming a lifelong learner, income seldom exceeds personal development. Communication brings the common ground of understanding. The world can always use one more great leader, leaving a legacy. The written and audio summary can be found on our website, bestbookbits.com. So without further ado, I bring you the book summary of 12 Pillars. The story starts off with a guy who is 40 years old, married to his wife for 15 years, that he is no longer is very connected with, and two kids who he barely sees, and a boring job where he makes about $40,000 a year as a sales rep. His car breaks down on the way to a sales meeting. He didn't have a phone, so he walked to the closest house. This house had a large brick and wrought iron fence stretched at least 500 feet along the roadside, and the gate was at least 10 feet high. Behind the gates was a house that was well over 10,000 square feet. It was a white plantation-style home that had 12 two-story pillars across the front, which made sense since the sign on the side of the gate said 12 pillars. He runs into the old man, who was about 7 years old, in some old overalls. The man asked if he could help. The man takes him to the garage and starts talking. The old man pretends that he doesn't own the home, which you find out later in the story that he does. Instead, he tells the young sales guy that he is the yard guy for a very wealthy man who owns the big house. They start a relationship where the sales rep comes by and meets the old man for months, and each week that he comes back to meet with the old guy, the old man teaches the sales guy a principle of the 12 pillars. So it is a story with a powerful message weaved in. Pillar 1, the only way things are going to change for you is when you change. A lot of people think working hard is the key to success, and it is, but it is only one piece of the success puzzle. For you to get a better job with more money and more opportunity, you must increase your skill set, which requires you to change your thoughts, your actions, and what you do every day. The conversations between the two of them are deep, and every sentence has a pearl of wisdom. Pillar 2, you should make sure that the outside of you is a good reflection of the inside of you. Pillar number 2 is a total well-being. The body is made up of three parts: the body, soul, and the spirit. You have to give equal attention to all three to have a healthy overall well-being. Pillar 3, time, effort, and imagination must be summoned consistently to keep any relationship flourishing and growing. The old man asks a sales guy to tell him about his family. He tells him about his struggles to find the time to spend with his family and that his relationship with his wife could be better. The message is that we must cultivate any and all relationships that is important to us. Just like a garden, it requires constant upkeep to keep the weeds out. If you don't weed for weeks, what happens to a garden? It doesn't take much time and the weeds will take over. It is no different for our relationships with our family, friends, and colleagues. Maintenance of a garden is easier than starting all over again. Pillar number 4, the major reason for setting a goal is for what it makes of you to accomplish it. Goal setting is deciding where you want to go and then designing a plan to get you there. Setting goals that stretch you and make you do things differently is what will lead you to a future that you want. Don't wait for people to set goals for you. Pillar number 5, every day has many opportunities, but only one best opportunity. We must all suffer from one of two pains: the pain of discipline or the pain of regret. The difference is that discipline weighs ounces and regret weighs tons. Your best opportunity each day are those that align with your overall goals and should be what you spend your time on. Don't just go through the day, get from the day. Don't spend your time on urgent, spend your time on what is important. We must be our own designer of our lives. Pillar 6, Don't join an easy crowd, you won't grow. Go where the expectations and the demands to perform are high. Ask yourself these questions. Who am I around? What effect are they having on me? What have they got me reading? What have they got me saying? Where do they have me going? What do they have me thinking? And most importantly, what do they have me becoming? Then ask yourself the final question. Is that okay? Friends of convenience. This is an interesting concept. It is easy to keep certain people as friends instead of pursuing new friends. Successful people look for the relationships with other successful people who will push them, challenge them, and encourage them to become better. To attract attractive people, you must be attractive. Not physically, but mentally, and who you are. Your attitude is greatly influenced by the people who you associate with. Your attitude is greatly influenced by the people who you associate with. Pillar 7, formal education will make you a living. Self-education will make you a fortune. Self-education is what you teach yourself. It is what you learn along the way so that you are constantly improving and growing. Most people don't continue to learn and grow. To separate yourself from everyone else, be focused on continuous learning. Learning is the beginning of wealth. Learning is the beginning of wealth. Learning is the beginning of health. Learning is the beginning of spirituality. Searching and learning are where the miracle process all begins. Most of life is lived after your formal education. That means the rest of it is up to you. You have to read the books. Books are and will continue to be the best learning tools of mankind. Pillar number 8. One key to having influence with others is to have others perceive you as a person of talent and virtue. All life is sales. All life is sales. Sales is really just the application of having influence, and that is a skill that we must all possess in life to get the things we want and desire. Talent and virtue are the foundation of successful influence and sales, whether you are selling a product or selling yourself, and a successful person is always selling him or herself. Skills of sales. Know your stuff. You can't teach what you don't know. You can't share that which you don't feel. You can't translate that which you do not have. You cannot give that which you do not possess. Talk to lots of people. Never take no for an answer. Pillar number 9. What you become directly influences what you get. The skills you develop to become a millionaire is more important than the money itself. Money can always go away. You can lose it. You can get sued. Inflation can eat it away. It can be stolen. Every year, you hear of what were once millionaires and multimillionaires having to file bankruptcy, going from hundreds of millions of dollars to nothing. However, many of them can come back from these things because of the skills they have learned to accumulate such wealth. The skills can never be taken away. Income seldom exceeds personal development. To increase your paycheck, you must increase your skills. Pillar 10, communication is two or more people working together to find the common ground of understanding. And when they find that common ground, they are positioned to have tremendous power together. Success is based on human relationships, and communication is the foundation for people working together. A lot of people spend their time communicating to convince the other person to their way of thinking. Instead, look for areas that you agree on and then build from that. Look for common ground. It isn't just what you say. It is how you say it, when you say it, and the receptiveness of who you say it to. And that is only half of it. The other half of it is making sure you really listen. Pillar number 11, to lead others is to help them change their thoughts, beliefs, and actions for the better. Leadership is a misunderstood concept. Most people, when they hear the term great leader, think of people who lead nations, corporations, or social movements. Leadership means you have mastered the art of influencing others. To lead others is to help them change their thoughts, beliefs, and actions for the better. Sales and leadership are similar because they are both the art of influencing others. Managers help people see themselves as they are, and leaders help them see themselves better than they are. If you want to get paid more, bring more value to others by becoming a better leader. Leaders talk about what they could be. Learn to help people with more than just their job. Help them with their lives. Great leaders are interested in people. During this book, each week and each meeting that the sales guy has with the old man, he teaches him the 12 pillars and the mythology around it. and while referring to a guy who owned the house, when the sales guy goes to meet him to learn the 12th pillar, he gets there and finds out that the old man has died. He learns this from the old man's wife, and this is when he learns that the old man was the wealthy guy that owned the house and came up with the 12 pillars. The final pillar, number 12, is given to the sales guy by the old man's wife in a letter from the old man, leaving a legacy. In the letter, the old man talks about the growth and development of the sales guy he has witnessed, and that is when he reached the final pillar on legacy. Pillar number 12, live a life that will help others spiritually, intellectually, physically, financially, and relationally. Live a life that serves as an example of what an expectational life can look like. You cannot choose how long you will live, but you can choose how well you live. You can also help others along the way, and when you help others, that is when you will build a legacy. Helping others and giving to others is what life is really about, and when you are dead and gone, be remembered for what you did for others and not what you have. And that's a wrap on 12 Pillars. Subscribe to the channel and take a look at the 100 of the book summaries uploaded previously. To find hundreds of written summaries, check out our website, bestbookbits.com. And for hundreds of audio summaries, find us on mixcloud.com/bestbookbits. If you want to help and be a contributor, get involved in the channel by reading a book, writing a summary, and emailing us at info@bestbookbits.com to have it featured. Thanks for watching and listening, and have yourself an amazing day. Take care.